welcome to Commissioners on the Record, the Robinson Response. It's been a couple of months since we've had a show, so we're back out though and looking to get started. And what a better place to start today than Pensacola Beach. We certainly appreciate the opportunity for you to be here to hear what's going on in District 4, and we're always excited to bring you new things. We're getting back out and going to be doing more remotes, but again, we're starting here at the beach today. We got so many things going on at the beach. Our first guest today, I'd like to walk over and introduce Chief Deputy Eric Haynes.
How you doing?
Chief Deputy Haynes, thank you so much for joining us here today.
Thanks for having me.
A lot of things going on at the beach. I know one of the big issues is open container, but before we get started on that, anything else that's going on at the beach, things that are happening? I know it's February, but before you know it, it'll be spring break, and then we'll be right into the summer.
Yeah, this coming weekend, our lieutenant out here, Lieutenant Forte, has already started scheduling a couple guys, starting to beef it up, and it'll be ramping up after this week.
Well, that'd be good. Well, I know you guys do a good job of making sure public safety is taken care of out here on the island. Let me ask you, I know one of the challenges that we've seen, we've had some challenges with some inappropriate behavior, and we're trying to deal with some of that, and we've come up with an open container ordinance. Now this is not a limited alcohol. You can still have alcohol. There are places you can have alcohol. You can even have alcohol in the sand. But this is for an open container to deal with congregations of people with open container in public areas that we're really not looking to have people congregate. So if you could kind of tell us a little bit more.
Yeah, there's been a big change in the ordinance. It used to be out here on Pensacola Beach that as long as you were walking around and not stopped somewhere, you could have an open container of alcohol. That's changed. I guess we're going to do like a 12 to 16 month experiment to see how it works. But you will only be allowed to have it in the restaurant areas and on the sand. And they will have those clearly marked. And then as far as the boardwalk goes, Quiet Water Boardwalk, the only alcohol again will be in the restaurants. And then they will have a little roped off area for each restaurant that you'll be allowed to be in. But other than that, it's going to be a significant change from what people are used to.
Well, and again, I've been in other cities that do the same thing. I mean, I've been places where that's happened. I think the challenge is it's not illegal for me to have a cooler of beer in the parking lot or even to have a beer in my hand as long as it's not open, correct?
Correct. Yeah, we're not trying to catch people that, you know, they're walking to the beach with a bottle of wine. These are going to be people that are drinking their wine in the parking lots.
Gotcha. Well, I think these are things we want to make the public aware of. There's also been a challenging, certainly we're talking about more public areas. The area that we're talking about is really commercial core, sort of from the beginning of the avenidas over to the, to the end of the hotel over there, over on the east side, all the way up to the bridge is kind of the area that we're looking at.
Right,
correct?
Yeah, the core area is where this ordinance is in effect.
If you're on the Sabine or you're over on the avenidas, this is not in place over there.
No, it won't affect you at all. If you're in the residential areas here and you want to go in your backyard and have, a glass of wine or whatever you want to drink.
In your front yard.
That's a front yard, wherever you want to be. So yes, this is the core area of the beach.
Okay. Well, I want to be real clear with everybody. When we also talk about the beach, the sandy areas, both on the Gulf Front and on the Sound, are also suitable for people to enjoy responsibly whatever they want to drink.
Yeah, correct. The shorelines, and again, just not in glass bottles as the ordinance goes. But yeah, certainly on the beach, that's still allowable.
So,
again, it's pretty much to keep people out of the parking lots, the sidewalks, and the boardwalks, imbibing too much.
I think we see when congregations, it's generally it's fairly dispersed on the beach. The issue is more the congregation that happens sometimes in the public area can lead to behavior that we don't necessarily want. While we certainly encourage you to come out here and be responsible, all the other laws still remain. We're not saying that you can go out on the beach and drink yourself into oblivion.
It's not against the law to drink. It's not against the law to drink too much. It's against the law when your behavior kind of crosses that line. So drunken disorderly. Not just drunken or not just disorderly, the two together is never a good combination.
Well, I think clearly when you got a tourist destination, there are a couple of things. We want everybody to have a good time. There's no intention here of not allowing people to continue to have a good time. We just want everybody to do it in a responsible way where they don't impact other people.
Right.
That's the real issue of what we're looking to do, not only for our locals, but especially for our tourists that come in from outside the area. So yeah. We want everybody to be on the best behavior when they come out to Pensacola Beach.
Exactly.
Well, is there anything else going on that we should know about? Anything else that's happening, events that are going forward that the Sheriff's Office has planned out here?
Not that I'm aware of. The next big one for us, of course, Memorial Day weekend is always big, but those are very well-behaved crowds that we have. Blue Angel will be the real big one, and we'll start coordinating with that one probably within 2 months or so. We'll start having our joint meetings with all the other law enforcement agencies and EMS, fire, everybody else.
Chief Deputy Haynes, I thank you so much for all you do. Thank you for being here with us today, but more importantly, what you do for Escambia County. I mean, I really appreciate what you do for everybody else, the Sheriff's Office and Sheriff Morgan, so we certainly appreciate that. Thank you for being a part of the show today.
Well, thanks, Commissioner.
We look forward to it. Absolutely. Yes, sir. Absolutely. Well, now we're going to step over and we're going to talk about some things that are going on. The Island Authority has taken a couple of the issues, public works and public safety, and provided those to the island. So we're going to go over to the pier and talk to some people about just what's going on and make sure that those things are all operating correctly, and let you know how things are going on the beach. So thank you very much, Chief. Thank you.
Thanks again.
Welcome back to the Robinson Response. Commissioners, on the record, we're certainly glad to have you, and I'm at one of my favorite places of the whole earth to be is right here on Pensacola Beach, on the Pensacola Beach Pier. As we talked about earlier, one of the things that we've done in Escambia County has been taking over the Public Works Department from the Island Authority. So we're here today with Wes Marino, in charge of Escambia County Public Works. Wes, good to have you. So glad. Thank you for joining us. We're here with Wes to talk about how that transfer's been and what's going on and what are some of the exciting things that are happening on the beach right now from Public Works. So kind of start off, tell us, you just started this in October.
We did. We started in October, getting to know the crew out here, getting to know the managers and the supervisors out here, and began the transition. And what I learned immediately was there's a great group of people out here that are taking care of the beach. They do a phenomenal job. And so they really made it easy. Everything from the Public Works, the folks in Public Works, and the folks at the Island Authority, we all came together. And really, it was a pretty smooth transition without hardly any hiccups at all.
Well, I think one of the things that sort of came to light for everybody is just how much actually goes on with Public Works. I mean, we have to do a lot of Public Works, but this beach takes a lot of maintenance. This 8.5 miles.
It does. It takes a lot of maintenance. And what I've learned since October is that there's very little downtime out here on the beach. I was out here this past weekend and Saturday, and it was just packed with people in the restaurants, on the beach, just trying to get to Park East and Park West. There's just a lot of people. And what that generates is, the trash cans have to be emptied more than once a day, and the bathrooms have to be cleaned more than once a day, and parking lots have to be swept, sidewalks have to be swept, and that's just the routine things. The other thing I learned was all of the special events that take place out here. You had the double bridge run this past weekend. We had to get out here earlier than we normally do, get the bathrooms opened up, make sure they're clean, stocked, and prepared, and then maintain those throughout the day. In the Mardi Gras parade that just took place, the Christmas parade that just took place, there's all sorts of events. Bands on the beach. These guys set up and help break down bands on the beach. There's so many things that they get involved in here on the beach that we don't necessarily get involved in there in the county proper, if you will.
Well, I think that's also a great point. All those things are open to the public. Certainly we're out here to enjoy, and we get our visitors from all over the world to come visit us. But these are also all events that are open to anybody in the Escambia County.
Absolutely.
So we highly encourage you to come on out here and be a part of those programs. There's always something going on, as you said. Tell us about some things that are actively happening now, maybe not just the day-to-day maintenance. We understand keeping the beach clean and all the things that you do along those lines, but what are some other things that are happening out here?
Well, we got a couple of big pushes. We have one, the Quiet Water Beach Bathhouse over there. If you notice it right now, it's in need of some repair and it needs a new roof on it. So we've just recently issued a contract. We're going to put a new roof on that. We're going to be pressure washing, sealing, and painting the whole bathhouse over there. Palm tree maintenance, as you see, we have plenty of palm trees out here, and so our crews are busy trimming palm trees as well. The boardwalk area, you're going to see a lot of sprucing up and freshening up there in that area, getting ready for the beach season. The public safety building you see over there, those guys are going to be doing some pressure washing, some going on there, trying to get it ready for the beach season. And then Of course, one of the biggest things is you see the new signs going up, no alcohol, the open container. That's a big thing for us. So we're really trying to get ready for March the 1st and make sure everything's in place there.
Well, we did just talk to Chief Deputy Haynes about that, and so that was good. We're getting everybody aware of what's happening. But clearly, I think some of the things that sometimes don't appreciate is the salt air and everything else out here just is a little bit harder on everything.
Absolutely.
So it creates more maintenance for you
guys.
It does.
It is very harsh, and that's something else I've learned through October. Even though you hear it all the time, hey, salt's really rough on equipment, it's rough on the signs, it's rough on the wood. If you notice some of the wood that gets weathered very rapidly due to the salt air, and it's just a harsh environment.
Well, again, I don't think people realize and appreciate the awesome responsibility you have. You take care of everything Escambia County, from Pensacola Beach and Perdido Key all the way to the Alabama line in Century.
Right.
So
right.
You are taking care of a lot of space in between. We appreciate all the effort that you and your team put together. I know there's a gentleman out here who's a great employee of yours, Mr. Morgan, Charlie Morgan. We sort of inherited him from the Island Authority. He's done a good job continuing to maintain things out here for you.
Well, you know, Charlie and his guys, while sometimes I hear, Wes, man, you did a great job with that transition, man, the beachless. Honestly, those guys are doing what they've always done, and they've always done a fantastic job. So for me, they make me look good.
Charlie, I knew when you were at the Island Authority, I know this is an Island Authority project, so it's not as much your project anymore, but I know we're starting to go. If you could kind of tell us what's going to be happening, what we're going to be seeing.
Well, the contractor has mobilized. As you can see, the dredge is anchored out offshore, and they're running their pipeline right now up to the beach. And they intend to start and run their pipes to the west, to Park West, re-nourish that beach, come all the way back to the midpoint, flip it over and go to Park East and come back with that. They intend to operate, they tell me, to operate 24 hours a day once they get started. They'll be around the clock till they finish. And it's going to be quite a job because we've had quite a bit of beach erosion out here. Some of these beaches are virtually gone up to the dune line.
You can just look down the island. It's so interesting. You can look here and it's very thick, but you can see not very far down the beach. It actually is quite narrow.
Yes,
as it scallops in and out.
Yes,
I think though one of the biggest things is we've been waiting for them to go because they've been out there since November, and it's we've had a lot of bad weather, had some other things happen unexpectedly, but from what I hear from you, it sounds like they're about to go any moment.
They're close, and it is very sensitive to weather. What we think may be good weather to them is not, because of the wave action out there on that dredge, is what they're telling me.
Well, this is certainly beautiful weather today, so we hope they're going to keep having more days like this, more days so you can come out to the beach and more days so they can keep going. The best thing is the shelling is going to be great. Lots
great.
Of shells should be out there after the re-nourishment, so that will be real exciting. But thank you again for updating us on that and all that you do for the county and the citizens out here on the beach. And we're just glad to have you as a part of the team, Charlie.
Thank you, Commissioner.
This is the largest park in Escambia County that we take care of, and we couldn't do it without great people like Wes and Charlie taking care of it. So I really appreciate all that y'all do. We're going to go talk to some other parts of the beach. Public safety is another part that's come over to the county. So we're going to go talk with the people at public safety who are watching over the beach to make sure you're safe while you're out here on the island. We're going to go talk to them and see how that's going, that transfer. Welcome back. We're here at the Robinson Response on Pensacola Beach. We're now at Public Safety. This is another department of the Santa Rosa Island Authority that has been taken over by Escambia County. And with me here today is our Director of Public Safety, Mike Weaver. Mike, thank you so much for being here today and being with us as we out here at the beach. A lot of things happening at the beach, and certainly you getting more responsibility out here. If you'd talk to us a little bit about what you and your crews are doing and what's going on out here, and then what we've got to look forward to over the summer and the upcoming months for public safety.
I'll tell you for myself, learning a bit about what the lifeguards do out here has been a little bit incredible. The amount of activity, the training, the response that they give the public when they're out here has been incredible. So we took over while they were in their off season and have been observing them. The amount of time that they are actually ambassadors out here dealing with the public, teaching them a little bit about what actually happens out here at the beach. And right now, the lifeguards are getting ramped up for spring break in the summertime, and they're beginning their training and orientation with the returning guards.
Well, I was about to say, today it looks very nice and calm, and you're not thinking about that too much, but I know the last couple of days we've had some pretty rough seas, and more importantly, I understand today y'all were out there doing some training with lifeguards, and it was pretty cold water.
Yeah, they're out here getting initiated in the cold weather as they're returning, but even on Christmas Day, when you don't think much about lifeguards, they were out here and actually doing rescues on that day. So even though it's a calm day and days that we in Pensacola may forget about them, they're out here and doing the job.
Well, again, other things that may be happening at public safety, I know there's a lot more than just lifeguards to making sure everybody's safety is taken care of out here. Other stuff, I know certainly EMS, the fire department out here reports to you. Anything else related to public safety?
Well, that with the fire and EMS, now adding the lifeguard, when there is somebody in need, now they're one big happy family. It's not probably the public never noticed it before when they called that they all work together, but now it just makes it that much easier. They're one cohesive unit taking care of the individuals.
Well, that's good. That's good. Well, and we have one of our career firefighting crews out here on the beach. They're out here all the time. Certainly the type of residential structures with the high-rise condos and a variety of other things are just different than what we have in the mainland, but they're out here all the time. I mean, there's always something going on. They have to be watchful.
That is correct. There's several different things here. You have more high-rises. You have people who live in these or in these condominiums that don't live in them all the time, so the chance of somebody being hurt or having a fire is increased. The winds add to that fire load. And these guys are kind of a jack of all trade. They also do water rescue. So they'll be pulling a boat with a four-wheeler, jumping on a ladder truck or fire engine and throwing ladders. So they're some pretty impressive individuals. And then with the bridges alone, they're kind of on an island by themselves for quite a while dealing with it. So another group of neat individuals.
Well, and again, there are a lot of people under Escambia County Public Safety that work here on the island. Take care of that. Certainly the bigger thing was to talk a little bit about some of the lifeguards and everything else, but we certainly appreciate all that you do, not only for Pensacola Beach, but really Escambia County at large, trying to keep us safe. I know we've had some major weather issues recently, but we appreciate you and your department keeping us safe out there.
We're fortunate for the folks we have.
Thank you very much, Mike. Appreciate it. Thank you. Well, now we're with our chief of public safety on Pensacola Beach and with the lifeguards. We're with Chief Dave Greenwood. Dave, thank you so much for being here. Appreciate you being a part of the new Escambia County team. How is the assimilation in working now with Mike Weaver and everybody else over at Escambia County?
Well, it's really great. We had good interoperability before, but now it's just when we tour the public safety headquarters, several of the employees will say, "Hey, welcome to public safety," and it's really good to be part of public safety.
Well, as Mike said earlier, it's a huge team. I mean, between fire, EMS, what you guys out here at lifeguard, there are a lot of people every day trying to make sure all the Escambia County citizens are safe. We want our visitors to be safe. We want our public to be safe. What are some of the things we should be thinking about as we hit the next season and what we need to do as we come out to the beach?
Well, be aware of the surf conditions, the flags that are flying. Red flag, we allow no swimming or wading. Surfers are permitted in the water. Double red flag, no one's permitted in the water. When you come through the toll plaza, take a few seconds to think about where you are and what you're doing and where you're going. Look about the environment that you're in. It's you can sometimes be overwhelmed by the beauty out here, but you have to realize there are risks inherent in the environment. Please don't put safety in the back seat when you come out here, because the last thing, you know, you can go to having a beautiful, beautiful day out here on this island to tragedy. Is it can happen very quickly if you don't realize and respect the environment you're in.
Well, I think that's certainly, we all love living along the coast and seeing what's out here, but water can be wonderful and beautiful to look at and tranquil, but it can also be quite mean and rough when it wants to be. So it's something we certainly appreciate your team being out here trying to take care of people. And I know today I hear y'all were out in the water, had a chance to get in the water. Yeah. A little cold for me. I don't usually come out this early.
Yeah, it's chilly, but and like I say, in 2 weeks we'll have the towers on the beach and there'll be people coming down from Michigan, Minnesota, and they'll be going in the water.
Well, that's good. That's good for them. I'll start waiting till June. I'll be out here in the water in June and late May. That sounds good to me. Dave, we certainly appreciate what all you and your team do in keeping us safe out here. Thank you very much. We're very happy to have you as part of the Escambia County team.
Yes,
so thank you for being a part of today, and thank you for all you do for Escambia County. Well, next we're going to go talk with Tim Day about turtles. So we've talked about the people, keeping them safe. We're going to talk some about keeping the critters safe. We talked about some public safety issues, some other things happening on the island. We're going to now talk about some of the animals here and the wildlife and trying to protect them. I'd like to appreciate Tim Day being a part of today's show. Tim, thank you very much for being out here and taking the time to be with us. I know you're very involved in many of the environmental causes out here on the beach. I know one of the biggest is dealing with turtle nest and trying to make sure we have the correct environment, ambient light and everything else. If you could tell us a little bit about that and last year's turtle season.
Yes, sir, Commissioner. This last year we had a pretty good year. We had 13 turtle nests. They produced about 1,000 youngsters that made it out into the Gulf of Mexico successfully. Recently, actually with your leadership, we've made some minor changes to our ordinances out here on the beach. This year we're implementing for the first year the Leave No Trace ordinance, which is a pretty simple ordinance to abide by. We ask that when you come out in the morning, bring everything that you want to play and enjoy your day on the beach. But when you leave for the day, please just pick everything up and leave only your footprints behind you. And at night, that way the turtles are able to come up and do the things turtles do. And we can share this beach with nature.
I think that's one of the things that I've found is at first when we instituted this, we had a lot of people coming forward and saying, well, this doesn't make sense. Why are you getting on me about doing this? And I said, well, it's not that we care one way or the other. The issue is dealing successfully with the turtle population we have. We don't know where they're going to come ashore, what's going to happen. So predicting where they come ashore and where you leave your stuff is just kind of an unpredictable situation.
Nope, absolutely. If we could go down there and put a road map and just direct them to the right spots to go, we'd be all set. But it's even this past year, we had a turtle came up, got actually in the middle of some folks' belongings and actually deposited a nest right in the middle of their little campsite. It provides some challenges for turtles on getting back and forth into the Gulf if we have those belongings. So we're just asking that everyone take care of their stuff, bring it off the beach, and let the turtles utilize it at night.
Well, that's certainly going to be one part of it. And it's exciting to know that we had 1,000 turtles come off this beach and go back into the wild, and that's successful in knowing that we're going to have future generations of sea turtles. It certainly is exciting to see them. I've heard people being out here on the fishing pier, snorkeling out there, seeing them. So those are certainly very exciting. But in addition to the Leave No Trace, there are other things that we can do to help the turtles, one of those being lighting.
Oh, absolutely. When we think about lighting and turtles, there's a couple rules that we kind of follow. What we try to do is when we install new lighting is we try to keep it as low to the ground as possible. We use long wavelength bulbs, which are amber or reddish in color. We keep it shielded so you can't see the bulb from the beach. And ultimately, we keep it safe. So regardless of everything else that we're doing with this lighting, we want to make sure that there's enough light for people to move around safely.
And it's my understanding we're going to be doing this in more parking lots in the core.
Yeah, absolutely. Last year we did a formal survey of Pensacola Beach and identified a number of problematic lights on the island. And we have some money now that we're doing retrofits with, and we're seeking additional funding through grants to assist both property owners and the county to be able to help darken our beach a little bit and make it a safer place for turtles to come at night, but yet still safe for people to enjoy.
Well, I know that's one of the things I know you've been very instrumental in following, and I'd worked with the BP related monies that came through NIFWIF. Mm-hmm. Many of those were to protect the critters, and one of those, the turtles. There's a lot of turtle lighting money. That's not just for public lighting, that's also for private lighting out here that can assist with that. So if people have questions, want to know what they might could do for their place, should they contact you?
Absolutely. Feel free to contact me or our department, which is Natural Resources Management at the county. My direct number is 595-1144, and we'll be more than happy to provide assistance to anyone on the island to see if they may have a lighting issue and what we can do to help them resolve it.
Well, Tim, thank you for all you do, taking care of Escambia County and all of the environmental part. We appreciate it very much. Thank you very much. Thank you for taking the time to watch. We got one other stop, and we're going to talk to you about some improvements that are going on out here with the roads, and we'll be talking to you in just a minute about those. Well, this was the segment of the show where we expected to have David Vorte from our engineering department here to talk about a couple of things that are going on in the island. But unfortunately, due to some of the storms and some damage that he sustained and his family, he is not able to be with us today. So we're certainly, our thoughts and prayers continue to go out to them and working through everything. But I did want to follow up with you and tell you at least a little bit of what I know is going to be happening. First thing is going to be the Bob Sykes Toll Bridge. The toll booth is going to be going to a SunPass system. At this particular moment, we do not have a confirmation exactly which day, but it will be sometime this summer. We'll be working through that with the company, and we continue to work through that point to find a date that is as soon as possible. This will be a great thing when it gets instituted. I'm sorry it's taking a little bit of time. Some of that's been outside of the hands of Escambia County. The second impact that will be happening on, and construction will be started, we'll be doing some traffic calming in front of Portofino as you come off of Park East, the National Seashore and Park East, and that straightaway before you hit where the pedestrian crossing is. We want to try to make sure the traffic slows down. So we're going to be doing a little bit of work to the road there that will be tearing it up and re-putting it back down, but we'll be doing so in a way that will hopefully be much safer to those both driving and those also crossing the road. We want to provide as much safety as possible. That work will be starting at the end of February, the beginning of March, and should be completing before the end of May. So again, just to let you know, there will be a couple of weekends if you try to head out to Park East, there will be some construction going on. Otherwise, we certainly appreciate you taking the time to be with us today. Like I said, we're glad to be out about and starting to do more of these programs. I'm excited about that and the opportunity to get back out and talk to you, the people. Let us know what things you'd like to talk about, and we'll be more than happy to put them on the Robinson Response. Until then, thank you so much for enjoying the show. Please come out to Pensacola Beach. Thank you.